Hi everyone, this is Sunny Kumar from Mathematics and Computing Part 2 from IIT BHU, and I am back again with Data Structures and Algorithms Coding Contest Problems of HackerEarth. So basically three problems are given, so let's discuss the first problem, events of arrays. Okay, so let's jump directly into the problem statement. We have been given an array A containing n elements, and we have to find the number of subarrays with even products. That is, the subarray is of an array can be obtained by deleting any prefixes and suffixes. That is, deleting either from the start of the array or from the end of the array, first n elements or first m elements, let's say, or from the both side. Okay. So input format is T, given the first test case is n, number of elements, and there are n space separated integers denoting the elements of the array. So we have to find the number of subarrays with even products. So let's understand this, how we are going to approach this problem. Okay, so let us begin. So first question that arises in our viewer's mind, when will the subarray contains product as even? So if any one element of the subarray, or let's say we have an array of m elements, and if any one element of the array containing m elements is going to be even, it is obvious that all the elements of the array is going, the product of the elements of the array is going to be even. Let's say we have 1, 3, 5, 7, and let's say, or if now you can see all the elements of the our current array is odd, let's say we have 8, which is going to be even. So if any one of the element is going to be even, then the product of the our current array is going to be even. And let's say we have 9 again. So if all the elements are going to be odd, then it is obvious that the product of the elements is going to be odd also. So this is our basic idea behind this question. So when will the subarray contains product as odd? When all the elements of subarray is going to be odd. That is, note that all the elements of the array, let's say. Okay. So our approach would be, let me write first. So total number of subarrays. Let's say total number of subarrays with containing total number of subarrays of n elements of the array would be our n into n plus 1 upon 2. This is obvious, as you must also understand this. Okay, so what our next approach would be, we are going to store answer initially as total number of subarrays, that is n into n plus 1 upon 2. And our next approach would be, we are going to store the indices of the element whose parity is going to be even. That is, the element is going to be even, we are going to store the current index of that element. So what is our next approach to approach the answer? That is, we are going to iterate in the vector of indices of those elements whose parity is going to be even. That is, if the element is even, then only I am going to push that index into our array. That is, let's say we have another vector that is going to store the indexes. Okay, so I am going to iterate in the vector and get the number of elements in the current subarray whose product is going to be odd. So how I am going to get the number of elements of that subarray whose product is going to be odd? That is, all the elements are going to be odd in that subarray. So that is, we can get by get consecutive difference of elements of vector minus 1. Okay, so this will give us the number of elements in that subarray where each element is going to be odd. So how this can be done? This can be done efficiently if we store the indexes of those elements whose parity is going to be even. So our next approach to get the answer would be, note that I have initially initialized my answer with total number of subarrays, and I have to get the total number of subarrays whose product is going to be even. So our next approach would be, we have to subtract the total number of subarrays whose product is going to be odd from our answer. Okay, so I am going to subtract from answer total number of subarrays which is going to be odd. So this will give us the answer as total number of subarrays whose product is going to be even. So let illustrate or understand this with an example. Suppose we have a array here, and let's, for simplicity, I am going to push back two extra indices that is going to denote the start of the array and for the end of the array and for simplicity in my calculations. Okay, so let's push minus 1, and for end of the array let's push out 4. Okay, so do not get confused. Now I'm going to iterate in this one. So or it's better to push first minus 1. Now I'm going to iterate in this array, and note that 3 is not even, 5 is not even, and 2 is going to be even. So we are going to push 2 0 based indexing index, that is 2's index would be 0, 1, 2, 2, okay. And now you can see 3 is also odd, so we are not going to push into our vector of indices. So finally I'm going to push 4 after the iterations in the vector, denoting that we are completed our vector of indices, okay. So how I'm going to achieve, let's say, note that here we have a subarray whose each element is going to be odd, that is 3 and 5. Again we have a subarray 3 where each element is going to be odd. Suppose we have a, let's say this is some easier example, suppose we have a array like 2, 5, 6, 8, 9, 3 and 4. So here we can see there is only single 5 between the two even elements, that is 2 and 6. Again we have a 9, 3 between the two even elements, that is 8 and 4. So how we are going to get this in most efficient way? That is, suppose we have a minus 1 and 4, that is denoting the end of the array. So if we want to get 5 and 3 as the number of elements where each element of this set is going to be odd, so I am going to subtract the consecutive difference of the from the vector of indices, that is 2 minus 1, and we are going to subtract one more for to get the number of elements. So our for to get 3 and 5, what I'm going to do is I'm going to subtract 2 minus minus 1, and again I'm going to subtract minus 1 also to get the number of elements, so it would come out to be 2. And from this 2, the total number of subarrays which is whose product is going to be odd will be 2 into 3 and the whole divided by 2. So this would be our total number of subarrays whose product is going to be odd for the current subarray, that is from 3 and 5. Note that it would be either 3, 5 and 3, 5 complete. So total would be, 3, okay. Again, for next consecutive element, that is 4, 2. Note that 4 is, I have appended 4 for simplicity in my calculations. So if we subtract 4, let's say 4 minus 2, okay, and minus 1 also for to get the number of elements, that is 4 minus 2, 2 minus 1, again 1. So denoting there is only single element. So total number of subarrays whose product is going to be odd corresponding to one value would be 1 into 2, the whole divided by 2. This would give us value 1. Okay, let me put a opening bracket here. So our total number of, so note that we have iterated the complete vector of indices. So our total number of subarrays whose product is going to be odd will be 3 plus 1, that is 4. So our answer would be total number of subarrays that can be possible with the n elements of the array would be 10 minus 4. Okay, 10 minus 4, let me say. Okay, let me check out. Yes, 10 minus 4 is going to give 6. Okay, so it's correct. Absolutely correct. So we would get 6 as our answer. So this is the basic approach of this problem. So let's move on to the code. Okay, this is the template of my code. So do not get. So I'm going to zoom out. So initially, I have taken the test, number of test cases, then n, the length of the array, and I have taken v. Note that I have pushed back minus 1 for simplicity of my calculations. So first, I'm going to iterate to the element and store the indices if the element is going to be even. So I have taken the input and I have done this. If A's parity is going to be even, I'm going to push back into my vector of indices. Push back I, that is current index, if the index is going to be zero based, as you can see here. Finally, I'm going to push back n, denoting the we have encountered the end of the array, and for simplicity in my calculations, note that I've initialized my answer with the total number of subarrays that can be formed. Now I've iterated in my actual array, that is vector of indices, now I've taken the consecutive difference, that is vi minus v of I minus 1 minus 1 to get the number of elements whose each element is going to be odd, that is that subarray where each element is going to be odd, because that subarray is going to give the total number of subarrays whose product is going to be odd. Okay, so I am going to subtract this value, that is count into count plus 1 upon 2 from my answer. Okay, so finally I am going to print my answer. If each consecutive element I have traveled through my vector of indices. So as you can see, the code has passed all the sample test cases, also the actual test cases, hidden test cases also. So this is basically the first problem of this HackerEarth coding contest data structures and algorithms. So if you have any doubts, do not forget to mention in the comment section of the video. And I will ask the viewers to like this video, share this video, join my Telegram channel, whose link is given in the description section of the video. And do subscribe to my YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you for watching this video.